Random House Audio presents The Present, The Gift That Makes You Happy and Successful at Work and in Life by Spencer Johnson. Read for you by Dennis Boutsikaris. Before the story. Late one afternoon, Bill Green received an urgent phone call from Liz Michaels, who he used to work with. She had heard Bill was experiencing great success, and she got right to the point. "Could I meet with you soon?" she asked. He thought he heard a strain in her voice. Bill said yes and rearranged his schedule so they could meet for lunch the next day. When Liz entered the restaurant, he noticed how tired she looked. After some small talk and ordering their meals, Liz told him, "I have Harrison's job now." "Congratulations," Bill said. "I'm not surprised you've been promoted." "Thanks, but the problems are mounting," she admitted. "A lot has changed since you were with us. We have fewer people, but more work. There never seems to be enough time to get everything done, at work or at home. And I'm just not enjoying life as much as I'd like to." "By the way, Bill," she added, changing the subject, "you look good." "I am good," he said. "I'm enjoying my work and life more. It's a nice change for me." "Oh," she said, "did your job change?" Bill laughed. "No, but it feels like it. It all came together about a year ago." "What happened?" Liz wanted to know. Bill began, "Remember how hard I used to push myself and others to get good results, and how much time and effort it took us to get things done?" Liz laughed. "I remember all too well." Bill smiled, as though amused by his old behavior. "Well, I've learned a few things, and so have many other people in my department. We're getting better results, faster, and with less stress. And to top it off, I'm enjoying life more." "What's happened?" Liz asked. "If I told you, you probably wouldn't believe it." "Try me," she replied. He paused and then said, "I heard a story from a good friend of mine. It turned out to be a real gift. In fact, the story is called The Present." "What's it about?" Liz inquired. "It's a story about a young man who discovers a way to live and work that makes him happier and more successful. After I heard it, I thought a lot about the story and how I could benefit from using it. I started using what I learned first at work and then later in my personal life. It had a big impact on me, and others began to notice. Like the young man in the story, I'm happier now, and I'm doing a lot better." "How?" Liz asked. "In what way?" "Well, I now concentrate better on what I'm doing. I learn more from what happens, and I'm able to plan better. I can focus now on getting the more important things done without taking so long to do them."
"You got all that out of one story?"
Liz seemed amazed. "Well, that's what I got out of the story. Different people get different things from the present, depending on where they are in their work or life when they hear it. Of course, some people just don't get it at all."
"The story is a practical parable," Bill continued. "So it's not just what's in the story, it's what you take out of it that gives it value."
Liz asked, "Can you tell it to me?" Bill sipped his glass of water and then said slowly, "Liz, I hesitate because you've always seemed to be so skeptical. And this is the type of story you might dismiss too easily." At that point, Liz let her guard down. She confessed that she was under a great deal of stress in her job and personal life, and had come to lunch hoping to get some help. Bill remembered when he felt that way. Liz said, "I really want to hear the story." Bill had always liked and respected Liz, so he said, "I'd be happy to tell it to you if you agree that what you get and use from the story is up to you. And," he added, "if you find it useful, that you will share it with others." Liz agreed, and Bill continued, "When I first heard it, I realized at some point in the story that there was a great deal more to it than I had anticipated. I found myself taking notes throughout the story to help me remember the insights I might want to use later." Liz wondered what she might find useful for herself. She took out a small notepad and said, "I'm ready to listen." Then Bill began to tell the story of The Present. The story of The Present. Once there was a boy who listened to a wise old man and thus began to learn about the present. The old man and the boy had known each other for more than a year and enjoyed talking together. One day the old man said, "It is called simply the present because of all the gifts you might receive, you will find this present is the most valuable one of all."
"Why is it so valuable?" the boy asked.
The old man explained, "Because when you receive this gift, you become happier and better able to do whatever you want to do."
Wow, the little boy exclaimed, although not fully understanding. I hope someone gives me the present someday. Maybe I'll get it for my birthday. Then the boy ran off to play. The old man smiled. He wondered how many birthdays would pass before the boy would realize the value of the present. The old man enjoyed watching the boy play in the neighborhood. He often saw a smile on the youngster's face and heard him laughing as he swung from a nearby tree. The boy was happy and completely engaged in whatever he was doing. He was a joy to behold. As the boy grew older, the old man couldn't help but notice the way the boy worked. On Saturday mornings, he would occasionally observe his young friend mowing the lawn across the street. The boy actually whistled while he worked. He seemed to be happy no matter what he was doing. One morning, the boy saw the old man and remembered what the old man had told him about the present. The boy knew all about presents, like the bicycle he got for his last birthday and the gifts he'd found under the tree on Christmas morning. But as he thought more about it, he realized that the joy of those presents didn't last very long. He wondered, what is so special about the present? What could make it so much better than any other present? What could make me happier and better at doing things? Wanting answers to his questions, he crossed the street to ask the old man. He asked what a young boy might ask. Is the present like a magic wand that can make all my wishes come true? No, the old man answered with a laugh. The present is not about magic or wishing. Unsure of the old man's answer, the boy returned to his work mowing the lawn, still wondering about the present. As he grew older, the boy continued to wonder about the present. If it has nothing to do with wishing, could it have something to do with going away to someplace special? Did it mean traveling to a foreign land where everything looked different? The people, the clothes they wore, the language they spoke, the houses they lived in, even their money. How would he get there? He went to see the old man. Is the present, he asked, a time machine that I could get in and go anywhere I wanted? No, the old man replied. When you receive the present, you no longer spend your time dreaming about being somewhere else. Time passed, and the boy grew into his teens. He became more and more dissatisfied. He had hoped he would be happier as he grew older, but he always seemed to want more, more friends, more things, more excitement. In his impatience, he dreamed about what awaited him out in the world. His thoughts drifted back to his talks with the old man, and he found himself thinking more and more about the promise of the present. He approached the old man again and asked, "Is the present something that will make me rich?" "Yes, in a way it can," the old man told him. "The present can lead you to many kinds of riches, but its value is not measured in gold or money alone." The teenager was confused. "You told me that when you receive the present, you're happier." "Yes," the old man said, "and better able to do whatever you set out to do. In other words, to be successful."
"What do you mean by successful?" the teenager asked.
"Success is progressing towards whatever you think is important," the old man answered. "For you, it may be getting good grades in school, doing well in sports, having a good relationship with your parents, getting a good part-time job after school, and then getting a raise because you do the job so well, or just enjoying life and appreciating what you have."
"So I get to decide what success is for myself?" the teenager asked.
"We all do," the old man said. "Success is something we all define for ourselves at different stages of our lives."
"Well, no one has ever given me a gift like that. In fact, I've never heard anyone else talk about such a present. I'm beginning to think it doesn't exist."
The old man replied, "Oh, it exists, but I'm afraid you don't yet understand. You may want to consider this. You already know what the present is. You already know where to find it. And you already know how it can make you happy and successful. You knew it best when you were younger. You have simply forgotten." The old man inquired, "When you were younger, mowing the lawn, was that a good time or a bad time for you?"
"A good time," the once little boy answered.
"What made it good?" the old man asked.
The teenager thought for a moment and said, "Because I loved what I was doing. I did such a good job that our neighbors asked me to cut their lawns as well. In fact, I made quite a lot of money for a kid my age."
"And what did you think about as you worked?" the old man inquired.
"When I was mowing the lawn, I thought about mowing the lawn. I thought about how I'd mowed the grass through the tricky areas and around the obstacles. I thought about how many lawns I was able to finish in an afternoon and how I could work so well. But mostly I just concentrated on cutting the grass in front of me. He spoke about mowing the grass in a tone that made it sound like the answer should be obvious. The old man leaned forward and said, "Exactly. And that is why you were so happy and successful." Unfortunately, the teenager didn't take the time to reflect on what he had just heard. Instead, he became more impatient. "If you really want me to be happy," the teenager said, "why don't you—"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.